SBS wishes to advise that the following program may cause distress to members of the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Island communities. It may contain images or voices of deceased persons.
G'day. Early last year, not long after he was elected in November 2007, Kevin Rudd got us all to finally say sorry to Indigenous Australians, this country's original inhabitants. But on that pretty stirring day, what was it exactly that we were apologising for? Stealing their continent? Stealing their culture? Stealing a generation still trying to find their way home, or what? Or were we maybe apologising for the destruction, deliberate or otherwise, of a timeless way of life, of what it actually means to be an Aboriginal Australian, a member of the oldest race of people on the planet? To many, our treatment of Indigenous Australians amounts to a crime against humanity. It's certainly true that governments elsewhere have been dragged before the world court for lesser crimes. If you think about it, this country is both an old country and a new country. The old one's theirs. The new one is the one we nicked 220 years ago. What you're about to see is the story of those two countries, theirs and ours, through the eyes and minds of two Indigenous Australians. It's also about the serious threat that their culture faces from industrialisation, from what we white fellas call progress. It's set in the Kimberley, the beautiful, pristine country in Australia's remote northwest, one of the world's few remaining wildernesses, and also in this area to the south, the not-so-beautiful, not-so-pristine Pilbara. But why don't we let Kimberley elder Roy Wiggan and his nephew Albert, Bardi men from north of Broome, do the talking. The Kimberley is their land, and this is their story. It's a story about a lot more than making a raft.
Done it with my people. Cutting wood, pack it up and stand it one chopped tree. Yeah. And then we come in and pick them up, and that's exactly what we're doing now. Proper old time work. But you'll never forget this. When can I go and make boomerang? When can I go make shield? I'm past the stage now. I can't do nothing. I only watch you boys doing things like this, and I'll be proud. Check him. There. Chop it off. Down the bottom, probably. There. Wonderful life. Wish I would be here every year. That's no good. Stiff. So it's one that they can use. When they start to shake and you'll hear the leaf, just like they were there. That's the right one. I'm trying to teach my son, my nephew. I want to teach him every damn thing that I can hand it down to them. Songs, cutting up dugong, cutting up turtle, cooking them how we was taught them. I'd like to see that happen to them. And I'll be proud to die in my old age. 70, 80 is a very, very long time. But I'll make it along. I've still got willpower to carry on. Never thought I'd be doing this thing again, even though when I'm helpless, but I got a lot of help. I've been taught how to read and survive.
One man made his own raft. That would be his bicycle. They camp in that island and paddle across next morning when it's dry, or midday, whenever the tide was. Then they pick two or three, that's all they can get, and put them in their catamaran and take them across to the island. Take their bark off, put them together, and when they had seven or eight, and they was finished, and they put them together, put their luggage, and off they go. They never left a person behind, unless he wanted to stay behind for a couple of days, or a week or a month maybe. Then they would leave him there. But they would make sure that they took him to where the water was supplied by the land. When you spear dugong, it takes you for miles. When you beat the dugong, you have to take him to a shallower water and fix your catamaran, and fix your dugong on the catamaran, and drag it back home. They used to tell him, look after yourself. What they meant was, as soon as you get sick, you got a light fire. Because you never starve in those days. You got a small language with enough, cook them, drink water from leaf. That's all I was told what to do, and here I am. I survived many times, in many ways. I done things exactly what my ancestors did. Paddle across from Sandy Island, incoming tide. Kill good melody. Go back. Same tide. Go back home with paddle. Everything that I was given by elderly people, I still carry it. Now I'm living in two different worlds. Modern type of living, where my law forbids me not to live in that area, but I have to live because it's the white man way. But I still manage to get around and do my own cultural things. And it pays off what my people have taught me and given me. They told me, Angela, you look after this. That's why I can't never let it go. I was a black man from the start that I was born, and I'll die a black man. Mark my words, you carry on with your culture, they'll carry on look after you. And that's where the payment comes in, because that culture, it's not by you or me. It's always been there and it'll always be there.
We started this way now.
That's right. Dig it out. Put your hand. You always feel it if it's smooth. You don't leave a peg too far out or get it through the other side too far. Building the raft, the main culture. If we stop doing the raft, we are dead people. There's no life in it. No life, no more. Nothing to talk about, nothing to think of, except be dead. Excellent. Making raft, it makes me proud. I'm still doing it. And I feel more proud I got my two sons working with me now. Modern new raft, making boomerangs, making spears. That's a rich gift that was given to me by my people. The cultural things that I can make, I can do. Because this sort of thing, it's your life. It's my life. Feed my family, fish, chair, jogong, travel around the islands. Amazing things that people can do with raft. It's one of the beautifulest things that you can hunt with.
Children of your dreaming, why don't you dance your dance, you sing your song? This country.
We finally built this galo, no? What do you think, eh? It's pretty good achievement, or what?
Very, very good, and it makes me really proud. All the work that's been done by you boys, I'm really proud.
There's something else we have to show you. It's about our country and about the big choices that Rasmov now as the next generation have to make. In regards to our country, we got to take you somewhere and we got to show you something.
I certainly would like to go and see the way that things have changed, you know? How far you boys have to go. but your courage have to be number one.
One mob together before the white man came. Many family mob connected throughout our movement.
Live in white man's life. We have to live in white man's life to earn money, eat white man taka. But there's a lot of taka that I don't have to eat. I hardly eat white man taka. I live on my own food.
You can tell there's no life here left anymore, you know? It's like it's dead already.
How did this become? How did this become? She says, oh, see, the bottle took my son. It took away my son. She says, oh, where are we going to run?
Area shouldn't be there. Because a white man's greed. You're being cheated out of your land. That land is still yours. It was given to you by God. The white man destroyed
Dad, this is what me and Jeremy wanted to show you now. This is what they want to put in our country, and this is what choices me and him have to make for the future, for our people and our country.
That bloody thing cut me, so cutting me to bits. When I first saw it, it's going to bite right through people. It's going to bite through, right through the earth. You won't have a land anymore. It's going to destroy our lifestyle, our culture, our food, our land. It's not a lifestyle. We couldn't put up with. And don't let them put another gas station up north. Leave it here. I'm going to fight it right through. How I'm going to win, I don't care, but I'll fight.
we're now finally looking for the first time exactly what they want to put up in our country. We don't feel well. I feel really frightened. This country is a beautiful country, you know, and it's like I can feel the pain coming through this ground. Like this country is screaming from hurt, you know. And that disgusting thing there, it's really, really scary. Kind of gives us no hope, really, where the blackfellas belong, you know. Where, as Aboriginal people, are we going to go? What's going to happen to our country? What's going to happen to us? We've been living a free life, a happy, peaceful life. We come from a homeland that gave us everything. Our country gave us life, and our country gave us our family, and our country gave us everything that we are so proud of and we are so happy about. And in return, we're going to turn around and put this there. How is our country going to survive? It can't survive. I'm shaking, you know, we're all shaking here. We're frightened. Something wrong with this place. There's something really wrong with this place. We don't feel right. Why can they not just appreciate that this is blackfella country, you know? This country means more to them than anything else in the world. But that's not important. That doesn't mean anything to white men, you know? Doesn't mean anything to the government. Doesn't mean anything to industry. They don't care. We already took them out of their homeland. We already taken them away and disconnected them to their country. All that is doing is just killing us, killing us, killing us. And all we got left over is money. What are we going to spend the money on? What's the point on buying a nice flash boat when we can't even go in our own place and go fishing? What's the point of buying a nice flash car when we can't even go back to our country anymore, you know? What's the point of buying a nice flash house when we already belong to a country? We don't need to buy a house. That's who we are. This is where we come from. This is our home. We come from this place. This country owns us. We don't own this place. This place owns us. Our job was to look after this country. Our job was to respect this land, was to respect one another. That's in our dreaming, that's in our stories, that's in our songs that was passed on for thousands of years. And now, they want to take it all away. The last bit of Australia, the Kimberleys, the last bit of Australia, which still have Aboriginal people living in that country, tells you that that country is still rich, that country is still alive, and it's happy, and it's free. Australia is so unique in so many different ways. It's not like any other place in the world. So it's got to mean something, eh? It's got to be valuable, you know? We've got to try and understand, how can we use the value of this country to survive, to live in this area? It has to start with small groups. Government expect one man or one group to change every black man's life. And that'll never work, that'll never work. Those black people gotta pick themselves up. Them black people gotta get up and move forward themselves. And the only way they're gonna do it is with strength from country, belief and pride for their land. Don't ever doubt yourself. You might not know anything. You might not know your law. You might not know your language. But if you believe that you belong to this country, that's all you have to do. That's all you gotta do. You gotta believe.
Well, when I became 70, and to up to where I am now, 78, I wanted to retire. That's when all people are retired. But I can't because I'm frightened. Because of things around about me that happens. And I've got no land to settle in my father's land, my wife's land. Everything has been taken over owned by somebody else. Are we black people rubbish? They came in 600 years ago and they've taken over our land. They've taken over our women folks. They've taken everything under our feet. And they don't seem to let go. You're coming in a boring, significant area. And this restricted area for Aborigines to dig in this country, and you're destroying a rich country. So because you're a government, we can't tell you. No, I'm telling you to pull away from it. The gas, where is it going to stop? Where will it all end? We're the owner of this land. Give us a go and let us make our decision for ourselves. Hey boy, we can kill dog with our own dog, sure.
What have we become?